Yo, what's up, guys? Dante here, back with another episode of Pokemon Legends Arceus. In the last episode, pretty much one very, very long tutorial. It's a lot of learning how the game works, the mechanics, essentially what we are going to do on our journey. This man right here, Professor Laventon, gave us our first Pokemon, which is the Cyndaquil. And if you throw him out, look at him. It's so cute. You can speak to him. He makes a sound. I don't know if that's... I guess he's happy, excited. So I figured something out. If you're standing up and you hit, like, Y. So you can't... Y is usually the dodge. But you can kind of do, like, a celebration type thing. Like, a pump him up. I never knew that. That's pretty cool. Anyway, let's put him back in the Pokeball. So today's episode, we are going to progress. We need to check our missions, and we need to accomplish research tasks. So last episode, I did the basic story mode element and. Yeah, so look at the Pokedex and okay, cool. So go ahead, check the Pokedex. I'm gonna open. And so essentially, we just have to complete enough tasks to basically get to the next level. So it's not too difficult. I'm not exactly going to complete the whole thing, I'm just going to do enough to get the task bar. So I'm at 160. I need 340 to get to the next level. So it's not gonna be too difficult. Easiest thing to do is just to catch him, basically. So catch you. And catch you. And I guess like we can cross some of them off. So we caught 3 of 3. Was that really all it was? Oh, okay, no. So that's that was the first tier. Okay, so to complete that whole section, you got to catch 25. Let's see. Let's do Cyndaquil. Let's get some of his up. So let's do. Well, no, actually, I'll just catch the Pokemon. Why not? That's the quickest, easiest thing to do. Just catch them. So the thing about what I like about Arceus is you can kind of move at your own pace. Now you obviously have to complete certain tasks to progress. But you have options. Like, I don't have to just battle them all. I don't have to just catch them all. I can do a number of different tasks Drift Bloom. Oh, I caught him in the daytime, too. Alright, got him in the Pokedex. Oh, that counts as caught at night? It was clearly daytime. I don't know. I don't think that counts. But I'll take the. Oh, I'll take the W. Let's see what else is out here. Whirlpool. Oh, come get you. Nope. Come back. Really? Stop. Quit playing. Okay, thank you. Stop playing me. I refuse to not catch a Whirlpool. excited for a second. Come on, Starly. I got you. So this is also another way to essentially grind, because there's no trainers, so you have to basically catch Pokemon, collect items, you can fight the Pokemon if it's easier for you. Oh, Shinx. Come here, you. I am pretty much just going to go until I run out of Pokeballs. Gadget. So I can sneak up on him, but he might turn around. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna throw this cherry berry. He'll turn around. He should go and eat it. Yep, he's gonna eat it. I throw this, and that should make it easier to catch him. Yep. Pushing. I think I've already caught boy like a couple dozen already, I think. Oh, not, no, I don't think that many. Probably about, say about a dozen or so. It's definitely more than 10, I know that. I don't know what it is. Like, people look at the game sometimes and they're like, I mean, they're like, it kind of gets tiresome, you know, you do the same thing over and over again. I don't know, I like it. It's like therapeutic. There you go. Come on. Come on. Oh my god. Come on. Oh no, he flew away. And he teleported. Alright. So, I think I should have enough points at this point. I'm gonna get these I'm gonna get these apricorns. And then we're gonna go back. I should have more than enough. Oh, he's asleep. Gotcha. You're asleep too? Why do y'all sleep? Oh, you woke up. Dang it. Come here. Come here. Gotcha. Oh, and I got a light specimen. I'm just knocking all these off, man. I think there's another one. Did I get the, I don't think I can do that yet. Oh, no, I can't. I can craft. Oh. Okay, so I do have the poke. Okay. I'll be here all. I will be here all day if I craft any more Pokeballs. So I'm gonna just go. Just catch these until I run out. So I catch 10 more. Ooh, gotcha. I don't know, man. Get your. There you go. If you don't stay. Stop, man. I can't give you any more back shots. This is ridiculous. Thank you. Golly. Before. We gotta make sure we get some Breezels. We gotta get the Breezels. Now, Breezel and. Shinx in this area are like the two most the two most aggressive Pokemon in this area. Ah damn, look, yep. Should I fight you? Fine, whatever. I know it's not effective, but it's part of the Pokédex. So this is actually a good way to knock out the task a little quicker. So if you have like a fire type and you gotta use like Ember or whatever move it is that you gotta use a certain amount of times, just make sure you're a higher level and just fight something that's super effective against you. That should help you out. Nah, I hope I don't lose. All right, cool. Heal you up because I don't want to die. There's a Weasel. Where'd it go? Ah, that's fine. That's cool. My only regret is that I didn't play this. I didn't record this and have a blind playthrough when it came out, but because this game, when it came out, man, there was just like, there's just some stuff that you just can't. You know how they say you can never have another first time? That's pretty much that's pretty much what this game was like for me. And like I said, I put in so many hours on my other save file. It's ridiculous. Like there was a point when I was playing this like religiously, like every day, man. It was ridiculous. All right, so we got 3 ball Pokeballs. Hope I can get 3 more. Awesome. 3. Got you. Come on. Yes. And I want to catch a Weasel. Well, you know what? Let's catch a Ponyta. Ponyta's a lot more docile. I don't have to beg and plead to catch it. Come on. Alright. Standing. All right, nice. So we got the Ponyta. Got the Ponyta filed away. And what do you have to say? If you're feeling worn out, have a rest in a tent. Okay. You can also rest there to pass time. Or if you're scared to be out surveying. Nah, man. Nighttime is the best time to survey, man. It's a lot of stuff you can see that you don't see during the day. Oh, wait, what's this? Oh, I didn't even see that. Alright. Come on. Oh my god, this is so slow. But this is the beginning of every Pokemon game. It takes forever to actually get some speed going. Even an open world game. And this does not make this move any faster. Alright, Professor. I've done what you needed. Here we go. I see you've caught 26 Pokemon. Care to report your findings? Alright. That's it? Nice. Alright, got a good piece of change. Oh, it seems you made some new observations. Let's have a look then. Mm-hmm. I see, most illuminating. I'll update our Pokedex with this new data. Alright, so then you can see, the check marks that are flashing? That is what you have accomplished for each Pokemon. And it also, like I said, you don't have to complete every single specific task. As long as you get up to 10, then it counts as complete. So I didn't get the Bidoof part, but Starly I got there. I think that was it, yeah. But that should be enough to get it to the next level. Yeah. Oh yeah, definitely. 5 out of 20. Yes sir. You make good progress on those research tasks, Yor. I do believe you're ready to move up the ranks. Let's head back to the village and report the good news to Captain Silene. It's time you earn yourself a star. Alright, let's get it. We are getting a star and moving up the ranks. Oh no. I told you guys in the first episode, I'm not doing any of the side tasks. I'm just going to stick to the main game. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do like separate videos for like all the side missions. Because there's so many side missions. It's actually insane. If you have progress to report, I will judge its worthiness. Show me your Pokédex. I guess you just open it and you go back and you close it. You have made progress. It seems you have earned yourself a star. With this, you have officially attained the rank of first star in the Galaxy Expedition Team. Alright. Nice. We are one star in. You can now use Heavy Balls. Pokemon up to level 20 will also obey your orders reliably in battle. The rewards you earn for your survey reports will be more generous now, too. Have these as well. They are further recipes you'll need for crafting. Alright, got the crafting Heavy Balls recipe. One Apricorn and one Black Tumblestone. So if you're wondering what the Tumblestone is, you see me hit those trees. That's why I get the Apricorns. The Black Tumblestones are not available yet. If I remember correctly, they're not. I don't think they're in this map. And we got the Revive, which is a Vivichoke and two Medicinal Leeks. I don't think we've seen Vivichokes yet either. I'll probably pick one up. I didn't realize that a stranger like you should fall from the sky yet flourish among us like this is a testament to your native talent and hard work. Most people prefer it when things are simple enough to be judged on face value alone. Improving your worth by moving up through our ranks is something anyone can understand. Keep at it, and even if you did fall from the sky, people may be more willing to accept you. Working your way through the ranks will also be a help if you wish to make a life for yourself here. A higher rank will grant you access to more types of Pokeballs and greater rewards. Alright, mission accomplished. For today, at least, you've earned yourself a meal at the Wallfire and a good night's rest. So you are my girl. I believe a jolly good congratulations is in order. Well done on earning your first star rank. Our usual order of potato mochi tastes even better when there's something to celebrate. Hey, by the way, have you taken on that request Beauregard had? Who is Who was that? I really forgot. I think I know who that is. I think that's the guard outside the building. Well, most people here don't know much about Pokemon. You've noticed, right? So it's our job at the Survey Corps to take care of any issues that crop up because of that. We're basically Pokemon problem solvers. Indeed so. Some Pokemon will ask you for help. Some people will ask you for help when you talk with them. While other requests will need to be claimed from the blackboard I keep in my lab. Speaking of which, were you approached with a request recently, Ray? What's it all about? That one might be a better fit for you than me. I don't think I'll be able to pull it off unless I get better at Pokemon battling. Ah, yes, that request came from my Diamond Clan, if I recall correctly. Oh my god. The people of the Diamond Clan have lived here in Hisui since before the Galaxy team arrived. If we could establish good relations, I'm sure there is much we might learn from them, including more about the local Pokemon. But we can discuss all that tomorrow. For today, we should eat up and get some rest. The next day. There's nothing like a good meal after a hard day's work and a good night's rest. You'd be surprised, those two things, you'd be surprised how much that can affect your day. It makes you feel so much better. Hey, Yor, before I go meet Maya about that request, mind showing me how you doing, battle? A bit busy here. Please just humor me. I have all these Pokemon on my team. I don't want to battle you right now. I want all the experience to go to Cyndaquil. Great. I'm at the train. Okay, cool. You can change your team up at the pastures, just so you know. Okay, cool. Alright, I'll see you there. Alright, so before I do that, I'm gonna go to the pasture and get rid of these Bidoofs. Because I don't need them. So I want to show you guys something. If you release you can't do that yet? Oh, they don't have that function yet. Okay, well. I can't do it. Alright, well. That's fine. There was something I want to show you guys, but I can't do it, so. Alright, so. I'm keeping Cyndaquil. That'll stay on my team automatically. But I'm also going to use. Is there anyone else I want to use right now? Nah. Oh. No. Yeah. So what we're going to do is I'm going to fast travel to the training grounds because you cannot move fast enough. Alright, let's get it. Thanks for taking a minute for me. I know your plate's full right now. I'm going to be straightforward with you about something. And that is, I don't understand how anyone can handle taking on Pokemon in battle. I know I'm a Survey Corps member, and I've even got my own Pokemon, but I just can't do it. Then why did you challenge me to this? Your partner? That's right, take a look at my very own partner. Pikachu, okay. This is my Pikachu. During that Shinx attack, I should have had Pikachu fight at my side. But my mind just went blank. And really, when you get right down to it, Pokemon are terrifying, right? Why should this thing be able to fire electricity? Acts of God, that's why. Did he call him a bigger? Chill out, Pikachu. But watching you at work completing those tasks, those research tasks convinced me. If I wanted to do my Survey Corps work well, my partner and I have to be on a team. I've got to be a team. And our first step towards being a real team is to battle your team. Alright, I get it. Survey Core Ray, challenge you to battle. Cyndaquil. Are you fast? Oh, shoot. This is a problem. Never mind. I thought there was going to be a problem, but he's fine. Alright, got the W. Battle decided. Whoa! You seem so in sync with your Pokemon. Are we really that in sync? It's really early on in a relationship, you know? Early on when you get like a new pet, you kind of give it basic commands. You don't give it anything advanced to do. That's all it is. The way that you fight alongside your Pokemon, you don't seem one bit scared of battling. I've been doing this for years, my guy. We just have to catch up as best we can, right, Pikachu? Pikachu, relax. Ah, fair enough. Pikachu's got a bit of tendency to attack, you see? That's why he normally stays in his ball. Oh, so they gave him like the reverse Ash Ketchum thing. If you don't get what I'm talking about, watch the first episode of Pokemon. Oh, by the way, the professor said Pokemon have these things called types, which apparently make a big difference in how battles go. Pikachu here seems to be an electric type, for example. Okay, this is the type matchup. I'm not gonna lie, to this day, I still don't understand it completely, because some of the type matchups still don't make sense to me to this day. Everything was cool until they got to like, when they added like fairy like, I know, I understand for like balance purposes, but some stuff just doesn't make sense when it comes to how stuff matches up. So you're the one, that new recruit everyone's talking about. Hey, the name Zisu, captain of the survey of the security corps. She is huge. I see you got some fight in you. Figured I'd stop by and get what advice I could. Captain Zisu is a master of an ancient martial art where you guide Pokemon in battle. Now listen, if your Pokemon has truly mastered its moves, it can actually use them in different styles. On the one hand, you can choose to deliver a move in the strong style. The move will deal more damage, but afterwards, it will take longer for your Pokemon to act. On the other hand, you can choose to unleash a move in the agile style. Such a move will have less power behind it, but your Pokemon can act more quickly afterwards. In truly favorable conditions, it might even get out two moves before the opponent can act. Strong style moves, agile style moves, and of course, regular moves. Choose which is right for a given situation, and direct your Pokemon with a little nudge. Oh, one more thing. If you want to teach your Pokemon some powerful moves, just let me know. Okay. Well, that's certainly handy to find out about before going to tackle Maze Request. You remember? I mentioned it earlier. I'm heading down now to see about Maze Request. It depends, I guess. It could be like May Valentine or like Mai from, what's her name from Avatar. I'm supposed to meet her down past the foot of Aspiration Hill. She'll come along too. Get ready. Then meet us down there, would you? And by ready, I mean double checking what Pokemon you're bringing. Maybe even teaching them some new moves from Zisu. Alright, man, let's go. Jeez. Alright, let's get this. Alright, so can I get anything now? So you can get moves, master moves, exchange items, and questions. Okay, so I just want moves right now. You, what can you learn? Ooh. That's some good moves right there. Aerial Ace and Swift. Huh? Alright, so we can't master moves yet. But I can change moves. So I'm gonna give him Aerial Ace and Swift. I don't, what would I need rollout against? Swift never misses, right? Yeah, Swift never misses. It's better than Quick Attack. That's actually a very good move to have early. Like in a regular Pokemon game, Aerial Ace that early is incredible. All right, so did he? She said something about, yeah. Okay. Someone said Beauregard. Oh, that, see, I think that's this guy right here. Like I said, this is a side mission. I'm not doing the side missions. So just going to strictly stick to the main core missions. Like I said, there's like 120, 30 of them. It's like, oh my God, I'll be here. I will literally, these videos will be 2-3 hours long. I'm not trying to go that far. Hour, hour and a half, tops. Anything over that, no. All right, looking clean. Boo! Did I surprise you? I bet I did. I was trying to anyway. There's a secret technique to catch a Pokemon, you see? It's what I call the secret backstrike technique. Hitting a Pokemon's back, pause, with your Pokeball will surprise them, making it easier to catch or give you an advantage once a battle starts. Hit a wild Pokemon from behind. Oh, I'm not reading that. He just explained it. If you're part of the Survey Corps now, you're working to create that Pokedex as they all are, you might end up meeting every last Pokemon here in Nisui. That is the goal. You should know I'm already looking forward to the day you accomplish that. Go. Alright, so where am I going? Yeah, so these are just requests. Okay, so these are the main ones. So I need to craft. Okay. I think I have a whole bunch. Let's craft. I have 30. Oh, that's the, I'm looking at the wrong thing. I have 4 potions. No Pokeballs. I'm gonna max out, go 40. Everything in sight. Ah, you saw me. Ooh, all kinds of backstrikes. Got it. All right, come on, Shinx. You can't see me through there. Shinx, stop playing me, man. Come on. There we go. Gotta get these apricorns, stay up stock, you know what I'm saying? You never know, you gotta make some kind of Pokeball. Alright, let's Let's get it. Yeah, get out of the way. I'm a one star. Do this kingdom. Over here. This here is your. My. A new face in the village? Not that it matters to me if you're new. If you're here, I assume you're prepared to be of help. Okay, so this is like, this is supposed to be like the 1800s. But she has on gear that's like present, like that's some present day type stuff. Like she's got on a sweatshirt. That's got symbols and markings and like prints on it. She got like Pokemon prints on the tights. Like, I know that was not a thing back in the day. What's going on? I am one of the wardens of the Diamond Clan. You may call me May. My. Mama call her My. Like My Valentine. Alright, I suppose you might not even know what a warden is if you're new to Hisui. But such talk can wait. Right now, I'd rather we get straight to the point. I have a problem that I need help solving. So the more important question is this. Do you feel confident that you can lead your Pokemon in battle? I do. I don't have a choice. That's good to hear. That security core of yours certainly wasn't up to the task. This here is my partner, Munchlax. We were raised together like siblings. He battles at my side by choice, without needing any silly little balls like you use. Watch and learn. I mean, if I have to body him, if that's what you want, sure. I can put him down if you want. That's what you want me to do. Where are you? Okay. Let's hit him with the aerial. Oh my god, you have rollout. Wow, yeah. Holy crap, I was planning. I got a burn, I think it's too late now. Wow, okay. I put my foot in my mouth. Jesus. Oh, I don't wanna. Oh, I don't, oh no. I guess. He missed. What? Oh, it starts over, that's right. The chain ended. I'll get the experience, it just won't be. Cyndaquil's not gonna get an experience, unfortunately. Damn. I did not know it had, look at that, that's crazy. You really aren't one of the usual galaxy buffoons if you could defeat my partner. Why they gotta be buffoons? Well fought, Munchlax. I'll take care of the Pokemon at Battlefield. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Because I really had to go all the way back. And I'll let you have these. You people make all kinds of things with your crafting, don't you? These should prove to be useful materials. Oh, the Vicachokes. That thing, that's for the potions. You and your Pokemon fought well together. You practically acted as one of them. Rather like the legendary hero old, the one we tell stories of to our children. I think you're indeed the one for the job. You see, I need someone to deal with an alpha Pokemon causing trouble upon Deer Track Heights. It is a large, fearsome foe like any alpha. But you'll come, won't you? To Deer Track Heights? What's going on? strange dingamy of yours telling you where to go? My, that is some curious sort of map. Is that one of those Galaxy Team inventions I keep hearing about? It certainly does seem to show the way to Deer Track Heights up ahead of us. I'll leave this bit to you. You shouldn't have any problem handling the Alpha. It seems you're quite the asset to the Survey Corps, new one. Though, before we continue, I must ask, do you already know about Almighty Sinnoh? Almighty what now? I suppose that's to be expected. Allow me to sketch out the basics. Almighty Sinnoh steers all time. It's said to have created the very universe using this power over time flow, and this land of Hisui was born in the process. It's by the grace of Almighty Sinnoh that Pokemon can live and thrive here. We of the Diamond Clan are descendants of a people who crossed the sea and settled here in the Hisui regions of venerate Almighty Sinnoh. However, it stole away from the world long ago, hiding itself from our sight. Almighty Sinnoh has only rarely been seen by any human, if the old tales are to be trusted. But there are still Pokemon here today in Hisui with a connection to Almighty Sinnoh. And it is the duty of wardens like myself to attend to their needs. The Pokemon that graces Deer Track Heights is one of those honored few. It is directly descended from a Pokemon that was blessed with Almighty Sinnoh's protection. Follow me, you may understand. Alright. So I need to go back here. Cause I don't want all these Pokemon on me. To catch something, but there's really nothing here that I want to use right now. Alright, so let's get it. Oh, I didn't see that. Free Apricorn. This way real quick. Cause there is something over here that I kinda wanna use. Alright, let's come on. Gotcha. Gotcha Shinx. That is Amber. That should be, oh my god. Whoa, what is going on with my screen? What's going on with the screen? Why is it pulsating like that? I can't get it to stop. Alright, it's over. Alright. That was weird. I do have to do some grinding anyway because of what happened with May. She bodied me. I was not prepared. Like I said, good way to train, to battle. Hit the trees, hit the rocks, the tumble stones. Get you level ups. All that good stuff. So we move on that. So I'm gonna come back, but there's something I want to catch. take a while, but bear with me. This just popped into my head. I've never used it in a playthrough or even on my team. I just kind of catch it if I do see it. Ooh, I got iron chunks. So iron chunks help you make higher grade Pokeballs. And I can't do anything with you. But actually, I can technically catch you, right? Let's see. Let's throw this over here. Go eat. I might be... No. You didn't see me. You didn't see me. Stop looking at me, Snorlax. Here. Sense. Oh my god, look at these beasts. Nah, we're not messing with them. We just started. It's already wild luxury out here. Oh, we got some Staravias out here. Okay. But you are not what I want, actually. Oh my god, this running takes so long. You are not what I want either. Although it has been a while since I've used. Should I use you? Let me catch you. Where are you at? Where did they go? Did they all disappear? Get the... Come on, man. I was nowhere near them. I wanted the Abra. I think there should be some more over here. I think. Nope. Stop it. Alright. Oh yeah, alright, here we go. Dang, that fool wanted to rip my head off. Gotta be careful. There's a Kadabra. I think it might be too... Should I start out with a Kadabra? Ooh, yeah, why not? I mean, if the Kadabra was there, I might as well, right? Come on, man. Why are you being difficult? Oh, no. Get away from me. Get away from me. I'm not messing with the luxury. And you teleport. Okay. Wonderful. Why are y'all so scary? Ah, yeah. Come on. Got him. Come on. Stand the ball, Abra. Yeah. There we go. Awesome. So I want you. I mean, I have to catch him eventually, but... Just for my team, you know what I mean? Where are you at? There's something I want to catch, but it's so far. There you go. There we go. I want you. Not, well, actually, can I use you? Or are you too strong? Are you too strong? Ah, 31. It's too good to be true. Come on, Shellos. Come back here. Come here. There we go. Oh my god! What are you doing? I'm not even near you, bro. Get away from me. Come on, please get involved. Alright, awesome. We got the shell up. That's what I wanted. Alright, let's get out of here. guy is gonna rip my head off. Oh, it's almost nighttime. Oh no. Oh my god, this is so, it's so long. I'm digging this analog stick into the controller. She does not move any faster. See, I'm so... Oh, never mind. Thought you were shiny. See, I'm so spoiled because I've played through the game and I'm at the point where I do not have to move at this pace. I am so sorry. But hey, man. You can blame Pokemon, blame them, Game Freak, for making the games this way. So there's a weird task. So you see the Snorlax. Let me see. So look how many times. Given food 50 times. Now that's not even like the highest. There's some task on here where it's like a stupid amount, man. It's like, it's later on in the game, obviously, but it's like a Pokemon. You gotta do something like 75 times. I'm like, there's one Pokemon. You gotta do a task for like 100 times. I'm like, good God, man. 100 times? Why? Why? Why do you need that done 100 times? That's crazy. We're almost at the thing. Alright, we're at the bridge. Oh my gosh. Or, no, actually. This is the other side, alright? Where are we at? Oh, maybe I gotta cross the bridge. Hey, quick attack. Actually, I want to use a Crobat. I want a Crobat. Let's get you. This is a very Sinnoh team, I guess. I mean, obviously, it's got Sinnoh Pokemon, but this is like a very... Can you get... I know you can get Oz, you can get Abra, and... Zubat this early, but can you get Shellos this early? You got Geodudes. And there go the black Tumblestones. Alright. Come on, we're almost done. We're not fighting anymore. Let's get on to the mission. What's this way? Oh no. Let's go this way. Already? Let's see. Oh. So even your professor decided to join us. That was actually a question. Lavinton. My boy. Whew. Thank goodness I got here in time. Ooh, we got an old school camera. As a Pokemon researcher, I could hardly miss out on the chance to observe an alpha now, could I? I suppose that is your business. Fine, as long as you stay out of the way. This is Deer Trek Heights. This is where I've long come to pay tribute to a special Pokemon. A Pokemon descended from one of those ancient blessed by Almighty Sinnoh. That's not it. That's only a troublemaker. Here to disturb the peace with his racket. Even the game acknowledges that Krikatoon is a nuisance. Now, I don't have no issue with Krikatoon, but his cry is like a running gag in like the Pokemon community. And that's what you're here for, Yor. To drive that interloper from this place. Interloper? Jesus Christ. I'm sure your Pokemon are ready for the battle. Are we gonna... Oh, you healed me. Oh, thank you. Okay. Upon my word, what a large specimen. Little wonder alpha Pokemon are feared across the land if they're all as oversized as this one. Exactly. They're not only big, though. They are strong and made no move that others of their kind do not. They're not to be trifled with, let me tell you. Nevertheless, I believe you are stronger still than this alpha. So go show it that, beyond any mistaking. Be careful, Yor. Size is a potent weapon in and of itself. No doubt this alpha is a powerful and hardy foe. If you must face it, make sure your Pokemon have some strong moves at their disposal. I should be fine. I should be fine. Let me put out Cyndaquil. I think Cyndaquil should be able to take the hits. That is ridiculous how big that thing is. That thing is like average human size. It's crazy. Speed action. Okay, so that's how you go from strong to agile. Oh, what the hell? That didn't do anything. See, there was something I wanted to do, but I guess I don't have that option yet. I guess I'll go Shellos. Got Ancient Power. Whew. Good thing I actually made up a team. I made up this team, like, on the spot. Now, this is obviously, this is like, these teams aren't set in stone. These are just like certain teams, just for portions of the journeys to get through it. Seeing someone best in alpha like that, it truly reminds me of the legendary hero of old. We'd best make sure your Pokemon are taken care of after facing against such a foe. Thank you. Now, usually in like other games, whoa, I wouldn't have an issue. What? What in the world? Hey, it's the Great Weird Deer. Or Wire Deer. I think it's Weird Deer. He looks upon you with kindness, Yor. I'd say the great weird deer has taken a liking to you. That is for there's still a Pokemon to this day I don't know how to pronounce correctly. He is an esteemed Pokemon that can dash across the expanses of Hisui by bearing a human on his back. A human he deems worthy, at least. He is a blessing to us all. Remarkable. Truly outstanding stuff. A Pokemon letting someone ride on it. Why, it's just like the ride Pokemon Alola. What do you know about Alola? Professor? Oh, Professor, I take it things went smoothly? I'm here on Captain Silene's orders. She said we'd be able to set up a base camp here once Yor took care of her request. Ah, about that. I know this was a joint decision by Adaman and the commander, but still. Is it truly fine for us to set up more base camps like this? The Hisui region is a land created by Almighty Sinnoh for the sake of his Pokemon. As long as your goal is to coexist and thrive together with the Pokemon, then I imagine you should also be allowed to use this land. The great Weird Deer has taken a liking to you as well. This is a good sign. You have my thanks for what you did today. Our clan leader will hear of how you aided us. I'll come to show my appreciation with a proper reward as soon as I can. Alright. Alright, thank you, Mai. Well, if we're to coexist and thrive with Pokemon, we need to know them better. And the first step toward that is completing the Pokedex. The construction corps should be here soon. They'll have our new base camp pitched in no time. Alright. So now, we have a new base camp, which means I don't have to run all the way here every time. Thank goodness. Here we have it. Our new base camp upon Deer Track Heights. I'd call it the Heights Camp. Very creative. From now on, when you set out from the village, you can ask to be escorted to this base camp to start your excursion directly from here. Having more base camps ought to make our survey work easier, huh? Well, that's that. How about we head to the Wallflower like usual? Oh, so, okay, cool. We're going back. Completed. We got completed Boudouf. What else did we complete? Okay. 240. Benny, old chum. The usual potato mochi, please. And make it for 3 today as well. Have y'all heard the grave news? That friendly Kleavor from the rumors ended up mauling some of our galaxy folks who went out to investigate it this morning. The medical corps has had a hard time getting all the injured back on their feet. Ah, this is the Kleavor that was reportedly struck by powerful lightning, yes? I did hear he's been behaving more erratically since then. Still, if further investigation is in order, the Survey Corps will, of course, step up to the task. A certain amount of danger is inevitable when researching unfamiliar Pokemon. True. But I'm sure Yor can handle things just fine. But that Kleavor, why does Ray look like that? But that Kleavor is said to be much, much stronger than even an Alpha Pokemon, isn't he? Now, you forget that the strength of Pokemon are key items of information that we of the Survey Corps are duty-bound to research. And since this perilous fight of ours calls for a clear head and fighting fit fatigue, I do believe a good night's sleep is in order after this fine meal. The next day. Rise and shine, Yor. The boss wants you. Commodore, that is. Get yourself to the commander's office. All right. What do you have for us? Let me go here. Get it. punctual. Finally realize you're wasting Almighty Sinnoh's precious time by bowing to a sham? There you go again, insisting on your false image of Almighty Sinnoh as a ruler of time. My people follow the true Almighty Sinnoh, the font of all creation and ruler of space, which is Dialga's time. Ha! You could have all the space there is and still not know what to do with it. That is very, very true. Excuse me, are you suggesting that we make better use of your time than we make a vast Hisui space? I mean, you both aren't doing either properly, if we're being honest. Y'all sitting here arguing, wasting up time and space. Better than some. It's a miracle you showed up on time, almighty leader of the Pearl Clan. I worried you get lost in the pointless vast space you're so fond of and never show up. Me? Get lost? In Almighty Sinnoh's great gift to the Pearl Clan? In our world's very basis? You wish. I wish that I hadn't let myself get dragged into arguing with you. Almighty Sinnoh, forgive me. What a waste of time. I'm off to Commander Commodore's office. I believe it was you who started this. These fools are arguing just to go to the same... Oh my god. Just another day with those two, I see. That man's name's Ottoman. He's the leader of the Diamond Clan. They put a lot of importance on time, as you can probably tell. And the girl is Irida, leader of the Pearl Clan. They're all about space. You remember she called it, right? Our world's very basis? Whenever they run into each other, those same arguments flare up. Seems like they've inherited some bad blood from their predecessor's strife. Oh well, not our problem. But you'll have problems if you don't get yourself to the commander's office, Yor. Alright, let's get it. Let's get it. Alright, let's go check, we go up? Yeah, we go up. Nope. No time for side missions. Getting straight to business. What do you intend to do about that Cleavor, Commander Kamada? He may be descended from a warrior of Almighty Sinnoh, but look at the mess he's causing. We can't sit back and let him rage on. You do get right to the point, Ottoman. Time wasted is lost. Well, tell me. What will you have us do? Cleavor is the precious lord of the Pearl Clan, is he not? That's the point. My clan can't intervene directly where a lord of the Pearl Clan is concerned. If my people were to do something, our two clans might end up back at each other's throat. Just like we used to. But even folk of the galaxy team have been wounded, haven't they? Seems someone's got to do something here. Who? Who then? Would the Diamond Clan have the Pearl Clan bring down one of its own honorable nobles? I don't believe I said that. Thought it, maybe. You might as well have said it, you fool. Look, we don't even know what drove Lord Cleavor into such a violent frenzy. I'd like to know that myself. This is the first, as far as my clan knows, too. I assume you arrived. This is Yor, the newest member of our Survey Corps. Aha! I hear from Mai you earned Wydeer's favor. Good to finally meet you, stranger from the Rift. I'm Ottoman, leader of the Diamond Clan, if you want to be formal. But that's a mouthful. Just call me Ottoman. If you came from beyond the space-time rift, could you be from the space where Almighty Sinnoh is said to reside? I'm Irida, leader of the Pearl Clan. Caution and foresight are my watchwords, which is why I have trouble believing such a tale. Could you really have passed through that rift? I have a proposition. Why not send this one to study Cleavor before deciding what must be done? You send this stranger who supposedly fell from the rift to study Cleavor? This newcomer with no experience? Says the leader with almost no experience. Being a good leader isn't a matter of time. It's a matter of embracing Hisui's vastness without fear. Being a leader isn't a matter of time. Okay, that makes no sense. Well then, there you have it. If how new you are doesn't matter, then let's give this kid a chance. I'm so, Commander. Let's try this your way. This should be fun. I get to see how good you galaxy folk really are, with all your weird ways. Putting Pokemon in the strange balls and what have you. That whole practice bothers me. Almighty Sinnoh made Hisui vast so Pokemon could live freely throughout. Yeah, y'all all about space, but you have Pokemon in Pokeballs. Which is one thing I wish they put in this game. You can't have Pokemon follow you. That would have been awesome. We're meant to stand alongside Pokemon, not count ourselves above them. We do not use Pokeballs from a desire to control our Pokemon. Only so that we can live together. Allow us to show you what we can do. This is your mission now, Yor. I order you to study Cleavor and help us find the truth of this situation. I accept. Remember that you are a stranger who appeared one day out of the very sky above us. People are naturally suspicious of your presence here. If you wish to be fully accepted and trusted, you must work hard. Work yourself to the very bone. The frenzy of the Lord Woods. Well, that's settled. And there's no time like the present. The Lord of the Woods, Cleavor, is descended from a Pokemon that was blessed with Almighty Sinnoh's own power. None of the Pokemon that you've yet encountered can compare to his strength. Be warned. Yeah, I'm gonna have to get these boys up. Listen to me. The Galaxy Expedition team has come to the Hisui region as a group of outsiders. Some might even call us interlopers. We mustn't do anything to threaten our relations with the Diamond and Pearl clans. Understand? Yes, sir. Join me downstairs, Yor. We'll cover the details of this new mission. You know what they should have did? They should make an actual sequel to this game, where you get to pick what team you want to start with, or like what clan you want to be a Diamond, you want to be Pearl clan, you want to be with the Survey Corps. Ah, good, you're already here, Professor Levinson. The briefing, if you please. Yes. Let's get right to it. So, Yor, I understand you've been requested to find out the cause of Cleavor's frenzy state. But as you are aware by now, Cleavor is a mighty thing, nigh invincible even. The Security Corps tried throwing Pokeballs at Cleavor when they were attacked, but I'm afraid they didn't even come close to catching him. It seems he's a far trickier opponent than even those aggressive species of Pokemon that cannot be caught outside of battle once they're roused. I'd like to be perfectly clear on this point. This mission will put you in extreme danger. Do you believe you can handle it? Do you believe you can handle it? Not particularly. I'll be honest, not particularly. I don't know about this one, Chief. Well, you have no choice in the matter. Oh, damn, okay, cool. Alright, well, I have no choice then. Let's go over the details you need to carry. You need to know. You have a mission to carry out. The Diamond and Pearl clans revere their nobles because they believe these Pokemon serve their almighty Sinnoh. They leave offerings to express their gratitude to these Pokemon in locations they call noble seats. So perhaps a good starting point for our research could be to find out what sorts of offerings they normally leave for this Cleavor. Okay. Yor, we need to speak with you. Listen, that that riff in Spacetime seems like it connects this world to a whole nother world. That world might be where Almighty Sinnoh itself resides. The true Almighty Sinnoh, that is. The one that rules over time. So if you fell through the space-time rift, that might mean you traveled through time. By Almighty Sinnoh's own power. Think of it. You must have just been swimming in his divine might. Well, I've got a favor to ask you, oh amazing time traveler. Don't just study Cleavor. Quell his frenzy. Well, you certainly call us at a good time, young Adamon. We were just discovering our next steps with regard to this whole Cleavor situation. Oho! You must be that Galaxy Team scholar I've heard about. Good to meet you, Mr. Professor. Share some of that knowledge with me sometimes. Now let me elaborate a little. Those Pearl Clan types have a lot of respect for Cleavor. You heard his title, Lord of the Woods. I'm sure they'd rather get this under control too. But it's hard for them to come right out and ask those of the Galaxy Team of all people for help. And the truth is, we in the Diamond Clan have a similar problem on our hands. The Pokemon dear to us, off in the mountains, has flown into the same type of frenzy as Cleavor. Now there's certainly bad blood between us and the Pearl Clan, but still, we've all got to share Hisui, and that means we ought to tackle our problems together. But there aren't many capable of standing up to such powerful Pokemon. You're the best hope we have. You'll find Cleavor at Grand Tree Arena. That's in the very heart of the Heartwood. His warden is a boy named Leon. Leon is a brilliant child, but also a bit, well, sometimes brilliance can be blinding, you know? He'll tell you all about his beloved Cleavor, whether you wish him to or not. Anyway, I'm sure you're up to the challenge, so we'll be counting on you. See you later. Wow, he just said his piece and then vanished. He must just value his time that much, I guess. I mean, straight to the point, right? And oh, no need for unnecessary words. Adamon and Mai weren't wrong, you know? If you're to study and perhaps even quell Cleavor, you best start by visiting his abode. Now that we've got the heist camp, it should come in handy for getting to Grand Tree Arena. And don't forget to visit the pastures. Choosing your Pokemon team carefully makes a difference. Oh, I know. Alright, so we are going to Grand Tree Arena. What? Finding yourself unable to pick up the materials you come across? Satchel always seeming full? If that sounds like you, it'd be wise to lend me your ear a moment to hear what I have to say. You can carry around even more in that satchel of yours if you learn the trick to pack and things in. I'll teach you, if you like. What do you say? Teach me. I like your initiative. My teaching fee is a neat $100, alright? Alright, I'll give you $100. Oh, that's just... Oh, okay. And that's all there is to it. You see how much more you can fit in by packing things rightly? If you want to be able to carry more things, there's more I could teach you. What do you say? $200. Alright. Let's keep it going. So basically he's just giving you more item slots. That's all it is. Keep it going. $300. How long does this go? $400. Let's ball out. Let's go all the way. I mean, we'll make the money back anyway with the missions. Alright, now we're at 1,000. Alright, so I'll go 1,000, that's it. Alright, cool. Alright. more space, as you can see. I went from 25 to, what is that, the 26? Did I get that, look at that right? All right, let's go on and get out of here. And let's go ahead and go on back to the obsidian. What happened? How are things, my good friend? Bruh. I certainly hope you're putting that secret backstrike technique I taught you to good use. Either way, I have some super potions here, just for you. Oh, think nothing of it. Having the Survey Corps out and about studying Pokemon is great for business, you know? Supporting you now is actually an investment in my own fortunes. I'm glad you're honest with me. Bruh, I remember the super potions were like 50, I think it was like 50 or 60 HP. There are 100 in this game. That's crazy. Like, times have changed, bruh. Let's go to Heights Camp. And I think what I'm going to do is, because this is a ways to go. Like I said, it's a lot of walking. You see how that's a long way. Now, if I had what I needed, because we have to go all the way around. So hopefully, my goal is by the time we get there, is to get everyone evolved. So Shellos doesn't evolve for a good while, but I need to get, alright, so I need to go back. Oh, Jesus Christ, she got air. I don't want to rest. So there's a thing, it sucks that I can't do this now, but because it'll take forever to do it the way that way. Oh my gosh. So I didn't know this feature was like later on in the game. So there's supposed to be like special things you get when you release Pokemon. I guess you get them later, but alright, fine. Alright, let's stop bulling around. Alright, let us go to Grand Tree Arena. So once we get to Grand Tree Arena, I think that's what I'm gonna call it quits. Cause I think we've gotten decently far in the story. Oh, you have water poles already? Oh my god. see, that just show, I'm not even paying attention, bro. Nice. Oh, we got some moves already. Oh, that was a thing? The feet of a water type? Okay. Who that? You? Okay. That's good. Shit, I'll start right here. Oh, 17. Alright. That's good. That's actually good. Good God, man. I don't have revives. Oh, okay, never mind. There we go. Ooh, yes, sir. Oh wait, though. I can evolve now. That's all I want. That's pretty much all I wanted. That'll definitely make this a lot easier. So it's not taking as long as I thought to get there. I thought it would take forever, but we're making some progress. Alright, so let's see. Are you over here? You're not over here. Dang, it's not over here. Oh yeah, it is. You are. That's it, it is. Come here. Oh my God. Are you kidding? Ah, that's crazy. Alright, what's in the tree? Burn me, okay. Ah, I wanted that Pichu, man. Oh, they would have been a joke. Is there another Pichu over here? They're over here. They're not super common, but you can, you know, if you're looking for them, you can usually find them. I think I'm going. Oh no, because I'm the way it's the area where it's at. It's I'm not going backwards. I'm just. Hey, more Bidoof. Ooh, we got Stardust. That's some money right there. Alright, what's in there? Combi? It's a female Combi too. Do I want to catch you? Or just kill you? I guess you're going down. Wow, okay, good job, do that. Don't worry, I know you're. Ooh, Baneri? Did I use Lopunin? I think I use Lopunin in my sword playthrough, so I'm gonna. Not this time, sorry. Maybe next playthrough or Maybe later on, I might use you. I'm trying to stay away from making like a dedicated team for the game, because the game is meant to. I can't go that way. The game is meant for you to, you know, branch out. You know what I'm saying? But I've used opening before, so. Go ahead and talk to Lynn real quick, and then we'll head out. I'm Lynn of the Pokemon of the Pearl Clan. Jeez, the Warden to Cleavor, Lord of the Woods. All I see is that dude from Driftville, and you. I've already decided that you come here to meet Cleavor. I'm right, aren't I? Of course I am. I can see it so clearly. After all, the powerfully awesome Cleavor has become even more awesomely powerful. Passed that strange lightning the other day with Almighty Sinnoh's divine power. But whatever it is, it struck my lord and left him imbued with awesome might. So I must turn you away, even if it pains me. It's too dangerous for you to meet Cleavor right now. That's that then. Truly. You mean to simply give up? Is your passion for Cleavor so paltry? But well, I'm afraid your passion is not the real issue here. I've been told in no uncertain terms by Irida that I am to let no one near Cleavor. I'll fight you off myself if you insist. If you wish to avoid battle, withdraw now while you still can. Or face the wrath of my Gumi. Let me bow out right quick. Hold on. So we're going to whip on. So he has a Gumi. I got a heal. I think Gumi is just water, right? What is Gumi? Water bug or is it water? Crap. I'm not sure. That's all you have is teleport? Okay. What do you have, Zubat? Alright. I cannot remember what Gumi is. What is Gumi? Gumi is water? It's just water, it's not dragon. Or is it dragon? Whatever. Let's get it. Alright, let's go. You don't even realize I'm turning you away for your own safety. How sad you are. Go, Gumi, and see if you can ooze some good sense over this foolish troublemaker. I don't even know what I made at the end. That was not a southern accent. Why are you in the front? Alright, whatever. Put you to sleep. And then I am going to... So yeah, bubble, okay. Right, Gus? Ooh, Gus. Dang, strong style. That's crazy. Dang, that's why I wanted that Pichu, man. Let's go Shellos. Muscle up, dude. 30. been defeated, but my point still stands. It's too dangerous to meet Cleavor now. The only welcome you get if you approach him is a fear of devastating blows. Normally, I simply try making him an offer. A nice heap helping of his two favorite foods, served up with respect by Lord Warden. That's me, of course. And usually enough to plead him and soothe the prickliest of moods. But even I, Cleavor's loyal warden, can't get closer to give him any offerings now. Not with the way Cleavor is rampaging and running amok. There's nothing that an outsider like you can do. The ancestors of Cleavor, Wadir, and their cohort draw on almighty Sinnoh's own power to protect Pokemon and people alike, so it's said. It's by their grace that our clan, that any of us, still lives in vast Sui today. Aorda, what are you doing here? As you say, Cleavor's grown even stronger, but I'm afraid that strength poses a problem for us. If he was indeed struck by that lightning, could the bolts have been sent by the false Sinnoh that the Diamond Clan bows to? Cleavor means so much to our clan. I'd hope we could bring the situation under control ourselves, not throw our hands up and ask some outsider for help. But we must save Cleavor for this frenzy. Every moment it continues, the danger grows. If more Pokemon and people are attacked, it will lead to conflict with both the Diamond and Clan and the Galaxy team. You, stranger from beyond the sky, tell me, could you Galaxy people actually fix all this? Could an outsider actually find a way to quell our Lord's frenzy? I figure something out. That's all I can do, bruh. Very well. Lian and I will gather food that pleased Cleavor in hopes that we might be able to get close enough to make him a proper offering. As for you, find a way to quell his frenzy, even if you must search every corner of Vast Sui. You need Arceus? Oh. So I can actually fast travel now. Okay, cool. Alright, so now that lets me go back and forth whenever I need. Alright, so that is that. We have made a lot of progress. We are introduced to Ottoman and Irina and Lian and May, I guess. We got one star under our belt. And yeah, I think we made some good progress in this episode. Caught a bunch of Pokemon, kind of have our team together. Sort of, kinda, maybe. There's no guarantees, no promises. But yeah, anyway, that is it for today. As always, hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching. And yeah, I'll see you guys in episode 3 of Pokemon Legends Arceus. All right, peace.